I'm not a fan of that sort of person is because I've done my homework. I've read everything I can get my hands on in the development of authoritarian political systems, and I know the literature inside out and backwards, and I am not going to be a mouthpiece.
Hey guys, welcome back to Talk Center. In today's video, we will be taking a look at some moments where Jordan Peterson absolutely owned people. But first, be sure to leave a like on the video and subscribe to the channel for more videos like this one and much more. Click the notification bell too, so that you don't miss out on any future videos that we upload. Now, let's get straight into the video. Number 1. Coming up next, we have a clip of Jordan Peterson on a panel with many transgender representatives. However, one of them claims that there is no biological evidence of only two genders existing. And Jordan disagrees.
You teach trans studies, so if you would, give us a brief primer on so many gender identities that in your view require non-traditional pronouns.
Basically, it's not correct that there is such a thing.
As you can see, this professor states that there is in fact no biological evidence that there should only be two genders. However, Jordan Peterson is quick to also disagree and states why he disagrees. Number 2. In this clip, Jordan Peterson takes a little dig at Canadian Prime Minister Justin Trudeau. Jordan believes that Justin had a moral duty that he didn't accomplish. He also says that Trudeau puts on a face in public because he knows how to act.
You have a moral duty, if you have the advantage of a name, you have a moral duty to supersede the accomplishments of the person who bore that name and gave it its weight before you dare capitalize on it in the public sphere.
Peterson also states that Trudeau also only hired people so he would have a higher male to female ratio. Peterson also said that you shouldn't hire people because of their gender, but rather because of experience and work ethic. Number 3. Jordan Peterson was stern in answering a question about being forced, so to speak, into using certain words or language. He was speaking to an audience, and they seemed to agree with what he said as they cheered him on.
I've done my homework. I've read everything I can get my hands on in the development of authoritarian political systems, and I know the literature inside out and backwards, and I am not going to.
Peterson proved his point by saying that he has studied it and done all of his research, and therefore he will not be sucked into what other people are saying. But he is firm on the belief he has come to having studied and done the research. You can see that he was clearly passionate about this. Number 4. We start things off with Jordan Peterson, who was on a news show and was debating about gender equality with a woman. The woman believes that men have all the advantages and that women are the ones suffering as a result. Jordan was against this argument, and he presented facts to set things straight.
Different choices and having equality of outcome.
Aha, well, so the overwhelming proportion of people who are in prisons are male. Now, do you want to equalize that, just out of curiosity? What about bricklayers? They're 99% male.
The points Jordan came with actually suggested that it is men that have it difficult in some cases, and this inequality thing the woman is speaking of is a myth. The woman did not seem to have a reply to what Peterson said. She was speechless as she realized he had valid points. Number 5. Next, we have Jordan being asked about what he would do and his views on the Canadian government having consequences when it comes to addressing transgenders with the wrong pronoun. Peterson's views on this are pretty firm and are most definitely controversial. Check out how adamant he is on what he thinks.
The tribunal is probably obligated by their own tangled web to bring me in front of it. If they find me, I won't pay it. If they put me in jail, I'll go on a hunger strike. I'm not doing this. That's that.
He genuinely believes that this whole pronouns thing is ridiculous, and he is not going to be drawn into doing it himself. He is in the firm belief that a woman is a woman and a man is a man. You can see him saying that he will not pay the fine or address transgenders with a pronoun they want to be addressed by. Number 6. It was reported that there would be no jail time for using the wrong pronoun when addressing transgenders, but rather there would be a fine instead that you would have to pay. Jordan was asked about it, and his answer was pretty funny. Take a look.
Misuse may become actionable through the human rights tribunals and the courts, and the remedies? Monetary damages, non-financial remedies, for example, ceasing the discriminatory practice
no
or reinstatement to the job,
he answered the question,
and public interest
asking
remedies,
what if he doesn't pay
for example,
the
changing hiring
clearly,
practices
he would not
or developing
have accepted
non-discriminatory
the jail time,
policies
but it's even more hilarious
procedures
that he finds the fine ridiculous. Those were some of the moments that made Jordan Peterson famous. Which one of these moments do you think is the best? Tell us down in the comments section below. Thank you guys for tuning into today's video. If you enjoyed it, then be sure to leave a like on the video and subscribe to the channel for more content like this and much more. Click the notification bell too so that you don't miss out on any future videos. That's all for now. We'll see you guys in the next one. Take care.